Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. The problem which we are going to solve now, we have solved earlier using two different methods, but we will try to solve it with another method in this particular session. So let's look at this problem, which is a very famous and interesting example. We have two opposite vertices of a square given to us. They are 1, 2 and 5, 8. We have to find out the remaining two vertices. We can solve this problem using fundamentals, the distance between the vertices, or we can also use it by using angle between the diagonal and the straight line. Now in this session, we'll try to use the concept of parametric equation of a straight line. So for that, what is our approach? Let's have a discussion about that. We'll discuss the steps, then we'll go ahead with the solution. What we need, what is the meaning of parametric equation of a straight line? Now you have a straight line on which you know a point x1, y1, and you know the angle it makes with the positive direction of x-axis or inclination. Then any point on that straight line which is at a distance of r units can be given by x equal to x1 plus r cos theta, y equal to y1 plus r sin theta. What's the meaning of that? The distance r can be divided into two parts, horizontal component and vertical component. Now suppose we want to move from x1 to x, how much distance we have to go? R cos theta. So can I say x equal to x1 plus r cos theta? Similarly, y equal to y1 plus r sin theta. Now we have to understand that the straight lines, whatever we see, are two types, one with positive slope and another with negative slope. Whenever the slope is positive, tan theta will be positive. Whenever the slope is negative, tan theta will be negative. Now our approach to solve this problem is, first, what we need to find out? We need to find out the coordinates of B and D. That means I need to have a point on that straight line. I know the point, that is midpoint, which is shared by both the diagonals. 1, 2, 5, 8, midpoint theorem. x1 plus x2/2, y1 plus y2/2, we got 3, 5. Now, once we know the point, we need to have the angle theta so that we can apply this particular formula. Now how to know the theta? Theta we want to know, we have to know the slope of this straight line. But we have two points AC, and we know AC is perpendicular to BD. So we can find out the slope of AC, then we can automatically find out the slope of BD. Once we know slope of BD, we know tan theta, that means we know theta. Then it is only couple of steps to find out the coordinates of B. Once we find out coordinates of B, we can again use the midpoint theorem and we can easily find out the vertex D. So our target is to find out what are the coordinates of vertex B. Then we will apply the midpoint theorem and we will find out the coordinates of D. Now to move ahead, we have to know what is the slope of BD and what is the distance R we have to go. Let's write down that. We need to know distance r, and also we have to know the slope of BD. To know slope of BD, first let's find out what is slope of AC. Slope of AC is given by y2 minus y1, 8 minus 2, divided by x2 minus x1, that is 5 minus 1, which is equal to 6/4, that's equal to 3/2. Now, once slope of AC is 3/2, we immediately know slope of BD will be negative multiple of reciprocal of that, so minus 1 into reverse of that, that's equal to minus 2/3. Now we know slope of BD is minus 2/3, that means tan theta equal to minus 2/3. Tan theta is minus 2/3, that means sine theta is equal to minus 2/√13, comma cos theta equal to 3/√13. Now how we are able to arrive at these values? We can take the tan theta, we can put a triangle there, tan theta, then we know this is minus 2 and this is 3. 2 and 3, we can find out the hypotenuse, that is equal to √13. Okay, now let's go and find out what is R. R is nothing but equal to OA equal to OB equal to OC equal to OD. So what is OA? Let's find out. OA is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square, 3 minus 1 whole square plus 5 minus 2 whole square, that is square root of 4 plus 9, which is equal to root 13. Now we know that R equal to root 13, so we know R. We also know the point 3 comma 5, that means we should be able to easily find out what are the coordinates of B. To do that, what we will do, we will apply the formula. We will write down x equal to our coordinates of B. I will write down the first one will be x1 plus r cos theta, that is 3 plus r, which is root 13, into cos theta, that is 3 by root 13, comma y coordinate will be y1, that is 5, plus r sin theta, that is root 13, into minus 2 divided by root 13. Now let us simplify that. That will give us the coordinates of B, which will be root 13 cancels. We will have 3 plus 3, that's equal to 6, comma 5 minus 2, that's equal to 3. So we have coordinates of B are 6 comma 3. Now once we know these are 6 comma 3, you can easily use midpoint theorem and find out that the other coordinates are 0 comma 7. And this graph, whatever we have, is the exact graph. So you can see that we got 0 comma 7 and we got 6 comma 3, which are the right vertices of this particular square. So let's have a recap how we have solved this particular problem. Now, given two opposite vertices, how to find out the remaining two vertices of a square is a very familiar problem, and we can solve it with different methods as we are learning different concepts. We can solve it using fundamentals, distance between the points and the relation between the diagonals and sides of a square. We can also use angle between the diagonal and straight, any sides which is 45 degrees. We can take the slopes and we can find out. That is one way of doing it, by knowing the equations of diagonals and solving them. Knowing the sides equations, we can solve them. The other way, what we can do is parametric equation of a straight line parameters. What we can do is, if we know a point on a line and we know how much distance we have to go along that line, given to us that what is the theta, or actually the positive direction of x-axis, the angle made by that line, then if we know indirectly the slope of the line, tan theta we know, then we can easily find out sin theta cos theta. Then x equal to x1 plus r cos theta and y equal to y1 plus r sin theta. Now in this particular problem, we have been given 1 comma 2 and 5 comma 8 as two opposite vertices. So first we found out what is the midpoint of 1 comma 2, 5 comma 8. That is 1 plus 5 by 2, 3, and 2 plus 8 by 2, 5. So we got the coordinates of midpoint of diagonals, that is 3 comma 5. That means we found out a point on the line BD. Now what we need to know is how much distance I have to go and what is my sine theta and cos theta. To know that, I have to know the slope of BD. To know slope BD, we started with what is slope of AC. We know two points. Slope of AC is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So slope of AC is 3 by 2, then slope of BD is minus 2 by 3. We know that diagonals bisect at 90 degrees in square. So slope of BD is minus 2 by 3. That means tan theta is minus 2 by 3. This line is with negative slope. What is the meaning of negative slope? You want to reach a point ahead in x direction, then you have to go down in the y direction. That means as you move in positive direction of x axis, the y coordinates will be going on reducing. That's why sin theta is minus 2 by root 13 and cos theta equal to 3 by root 13. Now we know what is R, the distance we have to go, that is OA, that is equal to root 13. Now once we know r, we know sin theta, we know cos theta, we can directly go and substitute the formula x equal to x1 plus r cos theta, y equal to y1 plus r sin theta. That gives us coordinates of b as 6, 3. The other coordinate we can easily find out, the opposite one, by using midpoint theorem as 0, 7. Now at the end of this video you will also have link to the other video which we have solved the same problem by using the angle between the diagonal and the straight lines and finding out the equations of all the sides and then solving them. So you can have a look at that example also. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now.